Good afternoon. My respected teachers sitting here and my fellow colleagues, I'm really grateful to the Scientific Committee of All India Ophthalmic Society and also to Dr. LG for allowing me to be here and share my experiences in front of you. I'm really, really grateful. As you know, Bangladesh ranks 8th for its population size, though it is a very small country. The total population is about 160 million and crude birth rate is 20 per thousand. Thus, approximately 3 million live births per year. There was a study in 2003 and 2004 by UNICEF and Bangladesh Bureau of Statistics. It showed that among all live births, more than one-fifth, that is 22.3%, are delivered prior to 35 weeks of gestation. Thus, about 4,25,000 premature babies every year born in Bangladesh. This is the whole scenario of NICUs in Bangladesh. They call it Special Care Newborn Unit by UNICEF. And they showed that here we have already 42 NICUs throughout the country, and we have a plan to develop 64 NICUs in 64 districts within a very short period of time. So there will be a huge number of premature babies in future in my country. In Bangladesh perspective, the ROP as a cause of blindness, at first it was told in 2004 by Dr. Kaji Shabbir Anwar. And you know, the NICU is established in 1990s, but in 2004 he first told that there are around 13% neonate below 1500 gram and born at or before 34 weeks suffer from low vision due to effects of ROP. Later on in 2008, another study in Dhaka Shishu Hospital, they also told that around 11.11% of the infants became blind due to ROP. So as I mentioned, Dr. Kazi Shabbir Anwar is the pioneer of ROP screening and initial awareness in Bangladesh, and laser was done by three prominent retina specialists in our country. Later, I had the opportunity in 2007 and 8 to be a long-term fellow of L.B. Prasad Eye Institute. As you know, there is a very well-organized and structured fellowship program is running there, and retina and pediatric ophthalmologists are encouraged to do ROP screening, and we are very much encouraged to do laser also in between in 1 month under Dr. Subhadra Jalali. So we learned to do ROP screening and ROP laser during our long-term fellowship. And after going back in my country in 2009 and 2010, we started ROP screening where I worked there at Islamia Eye Hospital. And we reported in 2012 that out of 53 ROP babies, 19 patients needed laser, and we did the laser. In 2011, Dr. Subhadra Jalali visited our country, and we held one national symposium at Islamia Eye Hospital, which was attended by all neonatologists, pediatricians, and ophthalmologists. Later on, lots of people are being interested to do ROP screening and laser, and a couple of ophthalmologists and retina specialists or retina fellows were trained under Dr. Subhadra Jalali, and also a few other doctors who are not under Dr. Subhadra, but they learned ROP from other institutes, and they are doing very good work in my country. In 2014, Orbis initiated another program with Islamia Eye Hospital, and they invited Dr. Rajwardhan Azad. He was there to formulate a national guideline of ROP screening and management. And in 2016, again, Dr. Subhadra, Dr. Padmaja, and Dr. Tapas visited our country, and this time, government of Bangladesh came forward, and we hold one hands-on training on retinopathy of prematurity, 1 week-long program, which was attended by a lot of doctors from throughout the country, and it was initiated, as I told, by supported by government of Bangladesh, and I must thank Professor AHM Enayathusen to take the initiative, who is the additional Director General of Health Services and a very prominent pediatric ophthalmologist of our country. And that time also, we organized a national symposium at my university, were attended by neonatologists, obstetrician, pediatrician, and ophthalmologists. And other than university curriculum and health policy groups are also present there, and they took it very seriously that ROP is a very main program, that is, it is a main cause of blindness in future. So the candle which was lit by Dr. Subhadra is now in, that is, it has been lit by in so many people in my country. But you see, it is only held in Dhaka city. I can mention at least 6 institutes who are working only in Dhaka city, and as much as that is the data I could collect, that in between December 2017, we have screened at least 4,349 babies, and 610 was type 1 ROP, and injection Avastin was given in 96 babies, 439 babies needed injection Avastin and laser was done in 352 babies. And very interestingly, we have started ROP surgery also, that is in stage 5 and 4A and 4B, and stage 5 babies we have already done in 41 babies, 65 eyes, the surgery has been done. But what about the rest of the country? This time, I think that we should think of what is our research. We have only 1,200 ophthalmologists in our country, around 60 retina specialists, and pediatric ophthalmologists around 40, but personnel involved with ROP screening and management, not more than 20. So in American Academy of Ophthalmology in 2006, there was a very interesting article that 54% of retina specialists and pediatric ophthalmologists are willing to manage ROP, and every year over 20% are planning to stop because of poor reimbursement, logistical difficulty, and medical legal purpose. So I think that we should always think of telemedicine to cover these people or to cover this problem. The telemedicine has potential to improve the accessibility, quality, and cost of healthcare, and may also contribute to medical education and research. And it in store and forward telemedicine program for ROP, images would likely be captured by trained neonatal personnel for subsequent grading by our remote ophthalmologist. And you know all about the Retcam, and in this article, it showed that the sensitivity and the specificity by different articles, different that is in different journals, it is over 0.8, that is 82% and 94%, 70 specificity and sensitivity, and the for moderate to severe ROP also it is very high, and also the kappa is very good, more than 0.9. That is inter-observer variability. So I feel that this tele-ROP program should be initiated by everybody. And already Dr. Anand Vinekar has shown the potential, and he has started in his state in Karnataka the program. So my future plan, my wish, my dream is to implement tele-ROP project in Bangladesh and to cover whole Bangladesh step by step. And already we have that is a project proposal we have already prepared, and we will submit it to UNICEF as we have planned. So in conclusion, we can tell that the scenario of ROP is changing in my country, and we are getting good support from all NICUs, and we know that more and more people, more and more patients will come, as because the NICU and the babies are surviving, and we are getting good support from NGO, government, and INGOs. And also we have a special bonding with my teachers in India. They are taking care of our children, and they are also teaching our doctors. And in conclusion, we can tell that tele-ROP should be of more use, and more NICUs are being established, so we will get more and more patients. But our aim should be within 2020, no premature or low birth weight baby should go unscreened for ROP within 20 to 30 days after birth. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your patience hearing. Thank you very much.